right, welcome back. They will play four times in the regular season, not meeting until January the 18th. Bush, the teams will look a little different on January the 18th.
Yeah, they certainly will. Obviously, the Devils, big club over in Czechia, get ready for their two-game set against the Buffalo Sabres. So some minor leaguers get another taste of NHL life in the last preseason game of the preseason season.
Not meaningless, though, for some of the Flyers players we talked about in the open who are still trying to make that last impression, a good last impression to the coaching staff. One's right there, number 15, Oleg Sell, who has had a good camp and could nab that second depth forward position. Noah Cates, of course, will be part of the mix, we would assume. He's out there, along with Anthony Richard, who also has a chance. So this line, certainly a lot to play for as the Devils move the puck through center ice. And Jake Stillman will get that puck in. He's one of their more highly regarded prospects playing in this game, and his pass knocked aside. Neil Andre had it for the Flyers. He was checked, but the puck bounces to Lixell, and he'll move up with it. Sell off on the right wing. Elder Granz joining the rush. He is checked, following up the play, though. Got it Hathaway in from the angle. That shot blocked off. Hathaway, a dad for the third time. Welcoming a daughter earlier in the week. That shot from the point. The save made by Poulter. And he's able to gather the rebound of the Andre Bitt. Well, congratulations to the Hathaways on the birth of their third child. I told him, three kids now, zone defense.
Exactly. I was just going to say that, no longer man on man or man, woman on kids, I guess. It's zone coverage.
It's zone. Just stick with zone defense. A shot from the point by Hunter McDonald that is batted away by Poulter, and then played by Ryan Schmeltzer up the boards. His pass across, and the Devils will move to center ice. Flyers 3-3 through their first six preseason games. The Devils have struggled 1-5, and their one win came with largely this group in a game they won a couple of contests ago against the Rangers. Jeremy Brodeur, who should get into this game in net. Yes, he is the son of Martin Brodeur. He stopped 29 of 30 shots in that game to get the Devils their only win of the preseason so far.
His dad wasn't even there to watch it. His dad was over in Prague. So, yeah. Good performance by the young Brodeur.
More recognizable names on this Devils roster is number 33. Just move that puck ahead. Jakub Zboril, former Boston Bruin, trying to basically resurrect his career now. Devils have the puck here. They move up with it. Mike Hardman to the Philadelphia line. Out it into the corner. He's able to get away and a shot from the slot. Good save there by Fedotov off of Hardman, former Chicago Blackhawk. And for Ivan Fedotov, this is the last action he's going to see before most likely his first game of the year, which one would assume would be the second game of the season in Calgary, the second half of the back-to-back to start the year.
So he wants to finish strong, right? You want to leave on a good note, positive note, have a good week of practice, and then get ready to go once the regular season starts for him. So it is an important, it's 30 minutes, important 30 minutes for Fedotov.
And as we mentioned, Alexei Kolosov will come in, and the gloves are down. Sawyer Bolton twisting and turning and taking a punch there as Samuel Laberge got one free and landed it. Did not last very long. Sawyer Bolton appears to want more here, but the he's been cut.
Right, he's a little woozy there. Yeah. He took a pretty good right from Laberge.
Yeah, he just went down again. And he's trying to tell the linesman Tommy Hughes there that he's fine, but they're going to send him off.
That's a right call there. Early scrap, good scrap. I think he's trying to say he's okay. He's trying to plead his case, but obviously some repairs needed as there's some blood on Bolton's lip. Good body check there by Laberge, and Bolton's there and goes a little high, and they decide to drop him, and like Bolton was trying to get loose in that right, right at the same time as Bolton was throwing and Laberge landed it and caught him right in the kisser.
Five each for fighting. And Bolton, of course, son of Eric Bolton, a long-time NHLer who dropped the gloves a time or two You're going to do that? You're going to get hit once in a while.
Yeah. It happens.
Good rise for the Flyers with the pass. And then Furry will move that puck ahead into the Devil's zone. To the corner, J.R. Abbott after. Now, DeNoyer centers it out in front. All the way out to Grimes, the former King property. Came over in the Provorov trade. He floated that one. It was deflected. It went just wide. And now the puck out to center. It's set in by Nate Laguerre of the Devils.
Oh, that point shot, boy, that took a strange bounce off the end boards. Lively boards behind Poulter there.
Bouchard trying to get in on the forecheck here against big defenseman Jackson Vandalist. 6'7" tall. Flyers come up with the puck in center. Cates is checked, and the play ends up offside.
Well, the Devils are credited with only one shot so far in the game, but it's a pretty good opportunity. The pass by Cam Squires out in the slot there, or off to the side, I should say. And Fedotov has to make a pretty good toe save on Mike Hardman. Best chance of the period so far between the two teams.
To get there is Kevin LeBanc, the NHL veteran, longtime San Jose Shark. PTO with the Devils trying to make the team. He's had a decent preseason, 3 goals last couple of games. Bodies together at the line, and now moving ahead is Bouchard. His pass tips goes to Oliver Vaughn. Back down low, off the goaltender. Kept loose in front, they score! Lixell digging away, able to tuck it home, and the Flyers, 4 minutes in, have a 1-0 lead.
Well, this is why you stick around the front of the net. You just never know. And Lixell kind of shrugs his shoulders. He found that loose change. Poulter really had trouble handling this puck. As this initial shot comes in, watch the puck hits his stick, then his pad. Right there goes off his blocker, and then he goes to tie it up. And Lixell was there to poke it loose. And for Poulter, I think when the puck hits his stick, I think he thinks it's going to the corner. It ends up hitting his blocker. He had no idea. He was down by his feet. By the time he figured it out, Lixell was there to pick up the loose change, and he pots it home for the early lead.
It's his second goal of the preseason. He has 4 points and 12 shots. It's 12 shots in five games. Give me an idea. He's been involved, Bruce. That's what he has to do to try to nab that forward spot.
Yeah. I mean, he's looking way more confident, way more assertive in this preseason than I remember last year. I think last year was more about survival for him, and he seems a lot more comfortable this year because he's had a really good exhibition season.
We're on the wall here by two of the big forwards for the Flyers that were brought in this year. Rico Hobbles. That's Eckler. Puck comes free. Hathaway drops it back. Eric Johnson getting some more preseason action here tonight at the line, the veteran. And here's the guy who's played in 987 NHL games. He wanted to get back out there and get some more action. He's been very good here in Canada.
Yeah, obviously a depth option for the Flyers. So, look, I mean, if he's not going to be in the opening night roster, which we do not know, but if he isn't, I mean, you want to get as much work as you can before the season starts, but obviously a real quality veteran, Eric Johnson, and having a good training camp.
And the longer he keeps playing, the better for you, Booch. He's going to be a broadcast.
Oh, yeah. He's got a future in TV, that's for sure. Keep playing, EJ.
Puck the flex free here for the Devils. Going to move it out, but they cannot. Furry turning with it at the line. Gets it off to O'Shea. Back to Furry for a drive and the save by Poulter. These are some of the players called up by the Flyers from the Phantoms. As they team up on that scoring chance, the battle in the corner for the puck. It's finally worked out of there by the Flyers with the centering pass. Garrett Wilson was blocked, and now the Devils move up. Hardman with the puck. Hardman waits, fires, and the save made by Fedotov. It comes right back out in front. It was tipped cross crease, but did not rattle home.
A good save there by Fedotov. Real patient. He held his feet. Didn't go down prematurely. Hardman tried to wait him out and go short side, but Fedotov with the patience.
Andre to DeNoyer. Not get the puck deep. Hunter McDonald has it back. McDonald will be part of that Phantoms D core to start the season. Guy the Flyers think an awful lot of. They're learning to play with the pace the NHL has, but he has the size and certainly the tenacity to be one of those stay-at-home, tough-to-play-against defensemen.
Mean with an edge. You got to love those guys. And needs a little bit more time. The more he plays, the better he'll be.
Pins his man on the wall. Eklund in there after the puck. It bounces free. Jack Malone after it, but Oliver Bonk there instead. Now McDonald ahead to Oscar Eklund, Swedish born. And the gloves are off, and here's some of that tenacity as Hunter McDonald will go. Hunter McDonald and Nate Laguerre. And a lot of pushing and shoving. Not sure many punches landed there. And the two are broken up. So, 7 minutes of play, two scraps, and also a Flyers goal. Will excel on the board. Flyers have one of them.
Playoff expectations and brought it back quickly, saying the goal is to build this hockey club, and was honest, saying the goaltending situation scares the crap out of him for this season. And honest about Sam Marison, saying he loves his mentality, thinks he can be the number one goaltender and has the confidence in him. But without Carter Hart in the fold, he said, I just don't know how this is going to work out. Says he won't allow himself to get ahead of where this organization is going, and thinks goaltending, guys, is going to be the biggest hurdle this season.
Well, I think if you probably polled most NHL head coaches, probably two-thirds of them would have the same answer, that they're, you know, it scares the crap out of them. But listen, you can only go by what you see. And, you know, so far in the preseason, to me, Arison looks really sharp. And Fedotov looks like he's calmed his game down a little bit from what we saw last year when he came over. So far, so good. We'll see how it plays out. But if I'm John Tortorella, I understand his trepidation. He's going to have to lean on Kim Dillabaugh and hope that he and the goalies get things squared away as quickly as possible. But if you're judging on what you see in the preseason, it looks pretty solid to me.
And then there's Alexei Kolosov. We have to see where he fits into the whole equation. For a while, it didn't look as though he was coming over. Now he's here. It is, we've mentioned a couple times, we'll see him here later on tonight. Devils get the puck into the fire zone, and Jitting is back. The bank tried to center that. It was blocked, and Excel the other way. Excel up the right wing. Pestered there by Stillman. A little backhanded along, but the pass from Richard was blocked off. Andre tries to pitch it back into the Devils zone. As we hit the 8-minute mark, Flyers out shooting the Devils early on, 6-2. Now the Devils will move in. That shot deflected away. The defenseman up on the play, Michael Diot. Now out at center ice. Hobbles roaring through. Slams on the brakes, lost an edge and went down. The Devils get it back, and Max Graham will play it this way. Meltzer will move it up. Graham has it back. In across the Philadelphia line. His shot into the red basket of Fedotov. It ends up in the net, but after the whistle, stops play. The Devils want to know why it's not a goal, and the officials will confer. Chris Rooney, Justin Keith, your referees Tommy Hughes and Kyle Flemington. Your line.
Yeah, I believe the whistle had blown. I mean, the part was when Fedotov was getting back up that the puck kind of squibbled through him. The officials are going to have a discussion. Let's listen. The whistle was kind of late, but I mean, you can see Fedotov. I mean, he knows the play is dead. As he's getting up, the puck kind of just dribbles down. I can't imagine that this would be allowed. I know the whistle did not blow, but the intent to blow the whistle certainly was there. I mean, there had to have been 3 seconds before Fedotov got up and that puck dribbled in.
They had a long conversation, but faceoff to the right of Fedotov, so no goal. And now Andre pokes that one ahead. Hathaway, the big Oscar Eklund, back toward Hathaway, back for Eklund. Oh, what a save by Poulter. Maybe it went off the post. What a play there now. Eklund down low. Hathaway in front. It caroms just wide of the net. This big line, and it is big. Puts some pressure on. Hathaway, good hit there. And now the Devils will move the other way with it. Vanderhoest gets the puck in. Hit absorbed by Obbles. Eklund will drop it back to Andre. Bronze. Obbles will turn back with it. Now Andre, who also still has a chance if the Flyers were to choose to carry 8 defensemen. He would have a chance. Here's Garrett Wilson. A pass. It ricochets in on goal. Poulter able to knock it down, grab it, and he'll take the whistle.
Well, Isaac Poulter with the his 7th save of the game, but his 6th save of the game was the good one. This feed across, and
Eklund with the one-timer. Look at that outstretched pad by Poulter. Terrific stuff by the Devils goaltender as he is able to keep this a one-goal hockey game. His best save of the night.
Clearly a save. Not sure why the referee signaled safe. Usually that means it hit the post. Not close to the post there. That was all bad.
It's preseason, right? We talked about that. We're nearing the end.
It still is.
Won't have that excuse.
Still have that crutch, yes. Not for much longer. Can't wait for the opener on Friday. Next Friday. Flyers win the draw. Bonk. Furry will flip one. That one goes wide. Bounces all the way back out to Furry. Twisting and turning in the corner. And now shuttling it, trying to shuttle it down low. Gauthier will get it behind the net. And take it down there with Jarrett Wilson. Jarrett Wilson's a guy who is certainly a candidate to drop the gloves at some point here tonight. Not afraid to do that. One of the veteran leaders for the Phantoms team. He's got some skill, too. He'll box some pucks. But he's a grinder. It's hard work. With Darryl on the wall. Furry comes in. Brings it back on the kick plate. Ginny is over. Down low, the Devils get to that. Ginny knocks down Squires, and Devils again have to go back and get the puck. It's Zboril ahead. That's intercepted. Good read there by Bonk. The puck, though, deflects out of play. Everybody lost sight of it, but it was out of play. We passed the midpoint of the first period, and the Flyers with a one-goal lead. The familiar face, Kevin Dineen. He's the head coach of the Utica Comets, the AHL affiliate of the Devils. He's the head coach here tonight as well. Former captain of the Flyers. A really great guy, Darryl Williams. Behind the bench for the Flyers, John Tortorella again upstairs, or at least not behind the bench.
One of Kevin Dineen's assistants is another former Flyer, Ryan Parent, a former teammate of mine.
Yes. Defenseman who ended up playing a big role in that run.
Yeah.
Back in 2010.
That was a fun team, that 2010 team.
Certainly were. Devils moving up, pass across the shot, and they score! Meltzer beating Fedotov on the rush. And the Devils tied at one here, past the midpoint of period number one.
I think for Fedotov on this one, a 3-on-2 rush, I think he was thinking that this pass was going to go to the Devil in the middle. If you watch here, as this puck goes from the wall right there, I think he's thinking it's going to go to that player. But Jack Malone lets it go, and Fedotov not able to get across on time, and the shot was perfectly placed off the inside of the pipe by Schmelzer, and the Devils tie this thing up.
His first of the preseason. Ryan Schmelzer played 357 games in the AHL without one NHL game. So you know he loves the game. Either that or he loves bus rides. But he's got himself an NHL goal, even if preseason game. Offside called against the Flyers there. Schmelzer is now 31 years of age from Buffalo. He went to Canisius and settled in as one of the veteran players for the Devils in their farm team.
Let's take another look at the goal as Schmelzer is talking about it on the bench. But again, when as a goaltender, when you read the rush, you recognize where the shots are. What are the righty or lefty? Is it a one-timer? Is it a one-touch? You see that guy coming down the middle for Fedotov. I'm almost certain he was thinking that guy in the middle was going to get the puck. But an alert play to let it go through, and that's why Schmelzer had time to rip the one-timer. So pretty good execution by the Devils.
Adam Ginning pulls that one along. Caught the referee on its way around. Dig for the loose puck. And Elise gets it out to center ice. Ginning will play it there. Ginning across to Granz and then right back to the Swede. He'll backhand in. And Elise back. Oh, he knocks down Noah Cates. Cates pops back up, and he had the puck when he popped back up. Richard could not do much with it. And wiping out was Bonk, and suddenly becomes an odd man rush the other way. Schmelzer again with the pass, the shot! And LeBanc went up high as Fedotov sprawled across, and the puck went out of play. I don't know if Fedotov got a piece of that.
Yeah, I don't know if he did or not. LeBanc, he's going to want that one back. I mean, beautiful pass across. Schmelzer, who has a goal, makes the feed, and yeah, I just think LeBanc airmails this one. I mean, he knows he's got to get it up as Fedotov is coming across. Just kind of shanked it a little bit.
A
LeBanc, who scored 17 goals back in 18-19 for San Jose. Had a tough year last year, only 2 goals.
Flyers moving up here. Penalty coming up. Abel's pass deflected away. Delayed call against the Devils. As Bonk will come out, play it across to Abel's. They move toward that empty net. Bonk will play it ahead now. Hathaway into the middle. Abel's there. Latfield will turn back with it. So patient are the Flyers here in this delayed penalty, but now Eklund is knocked off the puck at the line, and there's your whistle. The Flyers will go to the power play.
Jersey, minor penalty holding.
Brian Allen into the box for the Devils. That right arm comes across and takes down Bonk in the face as well. So the first power play of the hockey game goes to the Flyers.
Yeah, let's see what they put together here. They've got Cates, Lixell, Eric Johnson.
Jersey penalties number 48, Brian Hamilton.
And then Richard and Andre. So Johnson was lying down.
12 minutes, 15 seconds.
I think Brian so. Let's look. So they're going to play him up front here. Maybe he's in that front. We'll see. Here's Richard in across the line. And Richard tripped up, but the referees keep their arms at their side. Now the scrum for the puck. Cates tried to dig it out of there. Pass was deflected. Now finally does jam it through to Lixell. Lixell looking for an option here. He'll drop it off for Cates. Get it set up. Back to Andre. Tough pass to handle. Flyers now would be offside if they touched it. So the Devils allowed to move up. And Austin Dowling will hoist it deep into the Philadelphia zone with 1:07 remaining on the power play. Flyers power play in the preseason 5-for-20. Power play in the regular season will not include anybody I think we're seeing here. Never know. Here's J.R. Avon all the way around behind the net. It's Abel. Back to Avon. He's got some room. Takes a look. Fires. And that one, I think, went off a broken stick. And then up high. Ron's trying to keep it in. Bonk as well, but it deflects to center. Flyers do get the puck back. 35 seconds remaining on their power play. Oliver Bonk. Bronze it in, wind it deep. Holter can't stop it. Hobbles with help from Hathaway, but the puck ends up on the stick of Schmelzer. Dances out to center and then meets Oliver Bonk, knocks him down. Flyers get the puck back. Hobbles takes a hit to make the play to Granz. Granz in, drops it back. The shot. Holter, the save on Avon. Nice save by the Devils goalie. And then the pass back to the point is tipped all the way down the ice. Notov comes out and spins it over to Zhinning in front of that empty net. Power play is over. Devils back to full strength. Furry will play it into the Devils zone. Flyers arrive. Garrett Wilson with a big hit behind the net. Puck out to center. Johnson will get to Zhinning. Zhinning sends it right back into the Devils zone. Quite a bit of the play has been in this first period. They couldn't do much with that puck. Big hit there by Zhinning. As he said, Allen sprawling. Gauthier after a man in the corner. The puck deflects around. Furry back for Gauthier, trying to get that in front. Liotte cut that off. Devorl trying to clear. He's checked. Flyers have it back again. Furry with a shot. And Holter able to make the save from the angle. Bears tries to clear. Bonk knocks it down first with his glove, then whacks it across ice with his stick. Flyers need a change here, so some time for the Devils.
Some good pressure there by the Flyers and a real good read by Adam Zhinning as he was able to step up on Brian Allen in there along the wall in the defensive zone for the Devils, and really a good body check. Got to be our leading candidate for check of the game so
far.
There
you go. Crew heard that. That's more than just a hint. That's Brian Boucher making the call. Here's Eklund. Going cross ice. Benoit reaching for it, but did not come up with it. LeBanc tips it. Flyers let it go. Now they're onside. The feed to Avon. Avon over. Seat. Benoit follows up. Centers it. The shot. And I believe Holter got a piece of that one from Eklund.
Wonder if it caught the shaft of the stick, perhaps.
Benoit is. And raped all over him, but got that puck free. Ron's in deep. Will send it back out to Andre. Andre, little wrister, deflection. And he got knocked out in front. Played by Andy Walensky, a former Lehigh Valley Phantom, 1 year. We'll get it out to center ice, and then it's dished in by Dowling. Andre kind of waiting to get to that puck from Fedotov. And now he has it back. 22-year-old ahead, Luxell to Cates. Cates off on the right wing. Richard across, tipped away from Luxell. There's Swarm on the puck behind the net, though, and Cates comes up with it to Luxell. Gets it back out to the point. Richard is there. In low for Cates. Cates trying to get away from the checking of the Devils. McKinnon after him there. Flyers get it back. Here's Luxell turning with it. Luxell holds, waits, his pass to Richard. Back in front, the shot. It did not go. Cates with a drive, and Poulter goes sprawling back and somehow kept it out. Good pressure from the Flyers. Poulter's made some nice saves.
Well, the Flyers have spent a lot of time in the offensive zone, and Poulter's made some pretty good saves here in the last little bit. That one on the one-timer from Avon. Beautiful feed here by Richard to Cates. Cates not able to elevate, and Poulter gets across and makes a save, but the Flyers give him credit. They've been doing a good job of hunting pucks down, keeping plays alive, working in tight spaces, and creating some opportunities in front of Poulter here in this first period.
Poulter, 3 years of age. Undrafted player after 4 years in the Western Hockey League. Some time in both the AHL and the ECHL. Fedotov in some trouble behind his own net. The puck comes out. Flyers able to survive that, and Cates will just lob it down the ice. There's Richard turning on the speed and taking a hit. And Jaboral, and the Devils will move it across. Now Mishul. Mishul will get it back to Jaboral. His pass is ahead. Behind the player, Richard, very slow getting back to his skates. As the Devils move up with the puck. Suttery pass comes all the way across. That's going to be gobbled up by Luxell. He moves out with Hathaway. The pass to guarded. Hathaway holds, fires! That one takes off. Fires the line. Luxell tips Hathaway to it. A little stutter step move there. The puck got away from him. And Squires will move it up the wall, but not out. Obbles. Dumps it back into the corner. Eklund surges to it. With that big body, got it back to the point. That shot blocked in front. And now Squires got it through center ice. He got knocked down by Hunter McDonald.
Yeah, I think McDonald got away with one there. He kind of chopped his legs right from underneath.
Right in front of the referee. Here's Eklund. Obbles in the corner. He is checked. And at least those are two big bodies there. Eklund gets the puck free to McDonald. Now Monk right back to Hunter. And McDonald will send a deflection in the save made. Hathaway got his stick on that. Poulter another stop. That's 12 shots now for the Flyers. Devils have only four as we approach the final minute of this first period. Jack Malone up with the puck. It's passed tipped deep by Laguerre. Malone trying to get it back across for LaVerge, but the Flyers have it. Obbles did not clear. Hunter McDonald knocks it down. And now Garrett Wilson. He's a heck of an NFL receiver as well, Garrett Wilson. But that's another Garrett Wilson.
Should I say that's him?
Dual sport, NFL and NHL. I don't think we'll ever see that. I think we'll ever see that.
Modern day Bo Jackson.
Never say that. Bonk gets to Hunter McDonald. And now Brendan Furry. Furry gets the legs moving for Wilson. He was stopped at the Devils' line into the final half minute of this period. As the Devils make their way back, Dowling will wind it deep. And the bronze is there. Andre didn't get all of that. Boucher has to come back. Trying to keep it away from the Devils. They're scrambling a bit here, but bronze there and off glass to center ice. And then just 9 seconds to go in the period. The bank gathering the puck at the New Jersey line, turns with it, and he realizes the period's going to run out, and so that is it. There's 20 minutes in the books. Luxell on the board for the Flyers, Smeltzer for the Devils.
Get your game day gear ready for this season. The only place to shop the brand new 2024-25 Flyers jerseys is at shop.wfcphilly.com.
Tonight's first period between the Flyers and Bruins back out on the ice. His second period is about to commence in a 1-1 hockey game.
Take a look at some rough stuff in that first period. 22 hits between the two teams. Jackson Vandalese with a reverse hit there on Noah Cates. Adam Jennings stepping up. And there's some fisticuffs as well as LeBerge and Bolton go at it. And then McDonald and Laguerre fight as well. So we had a little bit of everything. We had some goals, we had some hits, some fights, and so there's 40 more minutes of this stuff.
Ed Sawyer Bolton has returned. He was in one of those scraps, took a shot. You can see some of the damage when he looks back toward us, the other side of his face. There it is. But good to see that he's back on the bench and ready to participate here in the second period. Jackson Vandalese has not returned to the bench for the Devils. Not sure when he incurred an injury in that period, but he is not with them as this period starts. Flyers dump the puck in. And that one deflects up over the glass and out of play. Just 11 seconds in. These teams, of course, in the Metropolitan Division. Flyers, for 143 days, were in a playoff position last year, but lost out at the end. The Devils had the biggest drop-off of any team in terms of points last year as they were hit with injuries. They got poor goaltending. Most people expect the Devils to be not only back in the playoffs, but up near the top of the Eastern Conference.
And I'm one of those people. I think when you add a goaltender like Jacob Markstrom, when he's on, he is very good. And he's going to be a major upgrade to what they had last season. So he's starting goal. That's a good addition. Brendan Dillon on the back end. Dougie Hamilton's back. So this is going to be a much different looking New Jersey team. New coach. You know, I think the expectations are right where they need to be. This is a team that expects to be in the top three in the Metropolitan Division.
Flyers are on the power play here as there was a delayed game penalty on that puck that went out of play. And so, Flyers' second man advantage of the game. Anthony Richard gets the puck in. Pops it off. Cell back out to the point. Andre. And across it goes to Eric Johnson. Andre for Richard. And that one chopped away from him by Nick McKinnon. And out through center it goes. Andre will most likely be running the power play for the Lehigh Valley Panthers. A great pass here. Hathaway in. Save made by Bolton. As Hathaway tried to make a quick move there, but the Devils goaltender had other ideas.
Great pass by Emil Andre as he's got his head up. Sees Hathaway coming off the bench, and Hathaway tries the pump fake, and Poulter doesn't bite for it. You can see that glove positioning. Look where the glove is for Poulter. Keeps it up. It never moved. Hathaway was hoping that maybe that leg kick would get him the bite, go down. Poulter never did.
Hathaway hoping that that dad strength is going to kick in there and get himself a power play goal. Poulter not going along with that scenario. 52 seconds left on the man advantage. Hobbles dropping it back. Now Avon gets the Devils line with speed around a man. The shot, he scores! A beauty from J.R. Avon, the 21-year-old power play goal, 2-1 Philadelphia.
Great job by J.R. Avon here to use his speed and protect the puck. And if you're a goaltender, you know, you don't think guys are going to drive into the net like this on the power play. You typically expect that maybe they drive, pull up, get things set up, but Avon takes it right to the net and is able to put it between the arm and the legs of Poulter. After Poulter made a nice save on Hathaway, he's not able to come up with that one on Avon, and the Flyers grab the lead once again.
An undrafted free agent signing by the Flyers off a camp tryout back in 2021, and he became a very important member of the Phantoms last year for Ian LaPerriere down there. So he can do a lot of things for your team, and with that kind of speed, you know, They're going to take a long look at it. He should be a big part of the Phantoms this year.
Well, what I like is, you know, you take what's given to you, right? I mean, just because you're on the power play doesn't mean you have to pull up and make a play. I mean, if it's there, take it to the net. And as I mentioned, I'm sure Poulter's probably thinking, no way this guy's going to take it to the net. He's going to want to hit the brakes and maybe get things set up. He's seen the surprise Poulter, and a real nice goal there for J.R. Avon.
Comes out to center here, but Dowling is stopped at the Philadelphia line. And now Hathaway back into the New Jersey zone. Robles picked up an assist on that goal, but loses the puck here. It is Dowling the other way. The veteran, 34 years of age, in for the shot, and the save made by Fedotov, and he'll melt the puck down.
Good save there by Fedotov. A little mix-up there inside the offensive blue line. Johnson was trying to find a hole to get open for Avils. Avils not able to elevate that pass, and Dowling, all by himself, tries to find a hole on Fedotov, not able to find it. Looked like he's trying to go far side. Yeah, good save there by Ivan.
There's the big goaltender. As we mentioned earlier, expect him to be playing in Saturday's game against Calgary. That puck deflects, goes wide of the net. As Gauthier took it to the cage. Now Zinni in the corner. Furry gets it back out for Eric Johnson. Across, Zinni can escape this one in, then drop it off for Gauthier. Back out, Garrett Wilson to drive. That's blocked by LeBears. But the Devils don't get the puck out of the zone. Furry, good job to keep it in. McKinnon after the puck, as is Gauthier. And now the battle in the Devils' zone. Finally, they control it. And Michael Diot is going to move it up to center. Andre for Grom. That's tipped. It was in on Poulter. First to the puck is Benoit. He's tied up, but Avon's there to dig the puck free. Avon, changing direction, sends it back down low, hoping for Benoit. He's got it. Benoit got out in front, tried to stuff it home. And it sat in the blue for a moment. Now he gets it back out to Andre. The gloves are off again here. And it's Bolton again dropping the gloves of LeBears. Bolton got a right in and another right in. Now LeBears trying to get his bearings back. A rematch of their earlier tussle. This one goes a little better for Sawyer Bolton, that's for sure.
Well, number one, good to see Bolton back here for this second period, and Chris Rooney giving him an earful there to tell him to get off and let it go. And as you mentioned, this one goes a lot better for Bolton the second time around. See there in the high slot, Bolton and LeBears going at it. The cross check up high. Here comes LeBears. He wants. Well, it didn't look like he wanted much. It's Bolton that really wanted all of it. Yeah, really, LeBears really not throwing much until the very end. And if you go back to that first fight, you know, for Bolton, if he lands that right, they threw the rights at the same time as LeBears just ended up catching him. It might have been a different looking fight.
2 minutes for instigating, 5 minutes for fighting, and a 10-minute misconduct. Huh. New Jersey 79, 5 minutes for fighting.
He definitely got the jump, but it was LeBears who kind of approached Bolton. So it's interesting. Usually those two items will cancel each other out in terms of an instigation, but there's no question Bolton had his gloves off first.
Well, the cross check up high by Bolton, you know, it seemed to get LeBears' attention. As LeBears was coming back, I would have thought for sure he would have been dropping his gloves ready to go, but he kept his gloves on. Bolton dropped them first, and that's probably why he gets the instigating penalty.
Well, they're discussing that very point right now. Out of the box.
If you only could get the mic down there, huh?
Yeah.
To see exactly what they're talking about.
You'd need a self-editing mic. But yeah, they do that. Who knows? Maybe a third scrum between those two is in the offing. If it is, it's the end of the evening.
Well, Barry is telling him you got to go. I mean, he's got 17 minutes in penalties. He's telling him get out of the box. There's only 16:46 to go in the period, but it looks like they're going to let him stay in. He's got a 2, a 5, and a 10, if I recall the call, right?
Your math is good.
Thank you.
You should technically
I think Sawyer's just saying, I'm not going to leave just yet. I still have a few more things to say.
So the power play begins for the Devils. Their first of the evening. Try to free this puck up along the corner boards. Andre, we get that to Cates. It was blocked off. Like the scrum here. Finally squares it all the way from the point comes LeBanc. They'll jam it around. Now Allen will send it toward the goal. Blocked off by Andre. Turning with it and clearing is Helgen Rons.
2 minutes instigation. 5 major fighting.
Those are the numbers from last season. The Flyers, of course, outstanding on the penalty kill. Fourth in league, leading 16 shorthanded goals. Devils middle of the road power play. They're hoping they have Jack Hughes all year long this year to help that power play out. There's Walensky. Cross ice back. That quick shot blocked by Hathaway. Eric Johnson finds a loose puck and flutters it out to center ice. Halfway through the bad advantage. LeBanc. Checked by Hathaway. And he'll dip back into his own zone. Brooklyn, New York native. Moves it into the Philadelphia zone. Jennings is there. He tries to clear, but reading that issue, we're going to hit it down low. It hops right out in front. Rotov just let it sit there for a moment instead of jumping on it or making a play. Flyers live to tell about that. And Johnson bounces it all the way down.
One hard.
We see moments with Fedotov where he's a little hesitant puck handling. He likes to handle the puck, Boosh, but I think still learning his teammates, what he should do with the ice surface.
Also preseason, maybe, you don't have the same level of intensity as you would in a regular season game. I would like to think that in a regular season game, he would jump on that puck.
Fleury trying to clear here was kept in, but now it bounces out of play. Just 5 seconds left on the penalty.
Well, the Flyers face off against the Vancouver Canucks during the home opener on Saturday, October 19th. All fans get a Flyers home opener t-shirt presented by Coca-Cola Zero Sugar. Tickets are on sale now at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.
The NHL season starts in, 16 to 18 hours? 1 o'clock Eastern time, I believe it is. From Chechen, 0-2 rink. The Flyers opened their season back in 2019. They did so against the Chicago Blackhawks. It'll be the Sabres and Devils tomorrow. They'll play two in Chechia to get the season officially underway. There's Hunter McDonald. Giving the puck to Oliver Bott. Now Fleury. Chip it. And he does get enough on it to get it out of the zone. Back to full strength hockey. Rashul will move the puck. Hartman is rammed into by Garrett Wilson. Puck deflecting, etc. Avon is after it. And now Vaughn corrals. To Garrett Wilson. And back to Avon, getting those legs going again. Avon swings wide to the left wing. His shot muzzled on the defense of the Devils. And Diot. Garrett Wilson doing the hard work. Got it out in front and hopped over the stick of Avon. And the Devils able to move it to center. Andre stops a potential rush. And the Devils just swing the puck deep into Philadelphia ice. Avoiding a check there with Schmelzer. Centers it out in front for a shot that went wide. And he's not able to get much on that with Jack Malone. Avon will get that up, and it does trickle to center. Garrett will get it back to McKinnon. Now off Schmelzer's stick into the Philadelphia zone. Andre is there reversing to Granz. He'll backhand it up the glass. And they're going to rule this icing. There's your whistle. The Devils were besieged with injuries last year, Boosh. They're hoping that this is not a sign of more injuries this year. Their highly regarded defenseman Luke Hughes will not be playing tomorrow or in the early season due to a left shoulder injury.
Yeah, it's tough. I mean, tough news for, the second-year defenseman. But the good news is they got Dougie Hamilton back. Obviously, as I mentioned before, they signed Brendan Dillon, and Brett Pesce is still out as well, I believe. So two really good defensemen in Luke Hughes and Brett Pesce, signing, coming over from the Carolina Hurricanes, are out to start the year. Those will be holes that they're going to have to fill as they start the year.
That hit the post from the severe angle. I didn't see it hit the post, but I certainly heard it hit the post as Granz moved it ahead to Denoyer. And now it's out in the neutral zone. And the Devils, very talented, explosive. I think they'll score goals. The question will be whether Markstrom and Ned and the additions you talked about on D will help them stop goals. There's a backhander and a Fedotov. And he makes the save there on Justin Dowling and preserves the Flyers' lead. They're up 2-1 here in the second, courtesy of that guy, J.R. Avon.
Of who is going to make this team, and all eyes on that eighth defensive spot. And John Tortorella, honest that that spot as of now is wide open. He said that he told the defenseman, what are you waiting for? And says he's disappointed that the defenseman haven't gone and gotten in force management to make the decision of whose spot that is. And a lot of those guys playing right now, and that's what makes a game like this, guys, so important.
Yeah, Adam Schitting's in his fifth game of the preseason as he talks with Brad Shaw right there. He was given every opportunity, has not performed as well as he would have liked. Andre's been good. So if they were to carry eight defensemen, Andre probably the favorite to be that eight, but there's significant questions to whether they would carry eight. Most likely they'll carry seven.
It's also, what do you want out of that extra defenseman too, right? Yeah. I mean, they're two different styles between Andre and Jennings. Jennings more of an in-your-face physical guy, whereas Andre's more of a puck mover, so that plays into it as well. And also, what happens up front? So a lot to be determined.
Evan LeBanc moving up, checking from behind as he went to fire that puck. Sure got it deeper. Richard and Bont work that puck free. It comes ahead of Noah Cates, who will swerve off the wall with it. Cates going to turn back here as both teams making some player changes. 8 minutes in to period number two. Bont for Hathaway. Surrounded by white jerseys. Knocked it out for Granz, who was able to jab it ahead. Now he's after it. Takes a hit as he twirls it down low. The Flyers get to that, but Abel's play in front was deflected away. New Jersey will move it up to center ice. This rule is checked by Eklund. And the puck back to Zaboral. A rink-wide feed for Graham is out of his reach, but no icing. Granz to Andre, and now Hathaway. Out at Hathaway. Good. Speed up that left wing. Got the puck in. Loved what he said to Ashlyn during the break about games like this. He says it's a privilege to put the sweater on.
Yep. You can see it. He's meant to be a Flyer. And, you know, comments like that from a leadership group or a leader like that, I think, goes a long way. And that's what they're trying to create around here, right? And that culture and that love for being a Flyer again. And I think Garnett embodies all of that. Get a look at him here on the rush. He avoids a hit here as Diot comes across, had him lined up, and that's the way able to avoid the contact there. But yeah, you're right. And I love when you hear older guys talk like that. To me, that type of stuff, it reverberates throughout the locker room.
Well, he signed a 2-year extension in the offseason. Shot for the point by Ginny was deflected just wide of the cage. Gauthier centers it. The shot by Garrett Wilson, snared by Poulter. And he'll hang on. And he gets some jabs being traded, but gloves are on for the moment.
Good stuff along the wall here. The Flyers have done a good job of owning the walls in this game. Johnson keeps it alive. Gauthier, not an easy play. Corral it on your back end and then make a play like that out front. Good stuff right there. And if not for the defender's stick, I think Wilson would have got a little more on that opportunity. So a good save by Poulter, but just some good stuff below the goal line by the Flyer forward.
Yeah, Wilson, 18 goals 2 years ago for the Fens, 19 3 years ago. The Nets off its moorings. Play is going to be stopped. They're going to say Garrett Wilson had most to do with the net coming off, so the faceoff's going to go back to center ice. In fact, we're going to get a penalty on this.
87 Philadelphia minor penalty interference.
So the faceoff's going to go all the way down into the Flyers zone as Wilson will visit the box. Take your team on the go with the Flyers Talk podcast. Watch and listen on YouTube or wherever you find your pods.
See Vanderleest and Wilson come together, and not much by Wilson. I mean, I think if Vanderleest just kind of holds his ground there, he doesn't run into the net, and there would be no penalty. But Chris Rooney saw it another way.
Big shot by LeBanc, blocked away by Fedotov. approaching the midpoint of this second period, so we'll keep an eye on the goaltenders because we could be seeing some switches. Alexei Kolosov doesn't give us any hints. He wears his mask the entire time on the bench. That shot from the bank goes high off the glass, and the Flyers clear the zone. I know you'd have your mask off around the bench. Show off those.
I was just going to say, what are you trying to say?
Well, you want to show everybody your great smile, right?
The time I left it on is if I got pulled in the game.
Yes.
And I didn't want to look at the coach.
I heard a story about a time you were pulled earlier today on XM Sirius Radio. Mike Johnson told a story about how you were so mad and you heard some.
Oh, is it the cowbell in Anaheim? Yeah, we started laughing. I was smashing things and then I had that skit there from Saturday Night Live with more cowbell, and we looked at each other and we started laughing.
Yes. He was relaying that story. There's LeBanc across. That shot from Zboril snared confidently by Fedotov.
It's the one where Will Ferrell says, Christopher Walken says, I've got a fever. And the only prescription is more cowbell.
Well, right now, the goalie change is going to happen in the middle of a power play, no less. As there is Alexei Kolosov seeing his first action here in Philadelphia. His second preseason game, he did get in relief. In the game on the island, 7 saves on 8 shots. Fedotov makes 7 saves on 8 shots here tonight. Something symmetrical about that. So Kolosov is in. Nothing like going into a game while the opponent's on the power play. And there's this quick shot. That one goes wide. There was a screen in front. And Hathaway's able to clear it all the way down the ice.
I guarantee you the heart rate gets right up to about 150. It's pumping pretty good when you get in there just in a game. And then throw yourself on a power play and it's beaten even quicker.
25 seconds remaining on that man advantage. Devils misfire on a slingshot pass. We'll have to go back and get it. No misshoot. Shields taken down and the Flyers have it back. Oliver Bonk. Give it to Hunter McDonald. And he will set it the length of the ice. So time winding out on that power play. Trying to get one last rush started. Get the puck in the cross ice pass, knocked down by Denoyer. DeVore reaching for it. Hoffman pushed it deeper. Now Schmelzer with a quick shot. That one rides up high. Off the glass. Back to it. The Devils. They'll move it in front. The shot, and they score. What a pass. And then a blast from Mike Hardman. And Kolosov greeted with a goal. It ties the game at 2 on. That had a lot of juice out. I'm not sure what the Flyers are looking at.
Maybe offside, perhaps. But this is a heck of a pass. I believe it was Cam Squires who made the pass. He made a pass earlier in the first period, too. On his backhand, he does it again here. Able to get around Denoyer. And what a beautiful feed. And Hardman rips this one past Kolosov. It's offside. That's what they were talking about. And I know earlier in the preseason there are no challenges, but there may be tonight.
Offside. Okay.
Chris Rooney
tipping his hand.
Yeah,
there.
That was more than a foreshadow right there. He said offside. They're looking for offside here.
And that last look there that we saw, to me, that's the smoking gun. Looks like this one will come back. Oh, yeah. That's an easy one right there.
Yeah. That should not take long.
Well, good for Kolosov because a tough situation to come into, right? And I know a power play, I know it would have been a 5-on-5 goal, but you want to get a little bit of a warm-up before you receive an opportunity like that. You should get it back to 2-1, and Kolosov can move on and hopefully shut the door after this.
And we'll get the call from Justin Keen.
After coach's challenge video review, it was determined the play was offside. So we have no goal.
No goal. Flyers stay on top.
The clock, 8:57.
AP and Vinny are not in preseason form. They're in regular season form.
That was an easy one. They'll never miss another one.
And it's still 2-1 Flyers. As a result, we'll be back.
Adam Ginning. A hit on Brian Hallinan in the first period, and they delivered it for us. And Beginning with our Wells Fargo great check of the game.
Everybody listens to you, Boosh, at all times. You have a commanding presence.
Sure. You do.
Not always hanging on your every word, but I try. But certainly our crew and guys and gals in the truck, they are listening to you. Whether they're not your broadcast partner is, I'll have to let us know. And then Curry getting that puck ahead and now taking it off the skate of Garrett Wilson. Goes across to Helge Granz. And he'll get the puck back into the Devil's zone. And down low, goes back out to Granz. Playing for Furry. Furry to the high spot. A quick shot in the stick save made by Poulter, who has stayed in the game. So apparently he'll play at least through two periods.
Good job there by Brendan Furry. Fans get front row access to Gritty's infamous skits and silly shenanigans at every Flyers game this season in Gritty's Chaos Corner. Learn more at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.
Whoever wrote that is setting you up.
I know. I got to take my time with that one. You're listening to that one, aren't you?
I certainly am, all year long. Hopefully that never changes.
Silly shenanigans. That's not an easy combination.
But very accurate when it comes to Gritty.
That's for sure. No doubt about that.
And Elise to Stillman and back for a shot. And that one from Dowling into the breadbasket of the 22-year-old Alexei Kolosov from Minsk, Belarus. There are his numbers last year in the KHL.
He's got pro experience and provides the Flyers with some depth right now. And I'm sure he has his sights set on being in this uniform right after camp. But you know, the reality of it though in the NHL, really in today's NHL, is the depth, the need for depth in the goaltending position. I've never seen more injuries to goaltenders like we see now. I mean, it's incredible. I think there's more scoring chances, much more difficulty of saves that puts goalies in tough spots. So you need to have organizational depth, and Kolosov hopefully will provide that for the Flyers. Good save there off the redirect.
Yeah, that was it. Nice save, showing that quickness it is. Swats that shot from Mandelis out of the way. That was putting some good pressure on here. Cates will end that with a spin move to Lixell. Lixell into the zone. Lixell and Richard get to Mandelis, but help from Dowling gets the puck to center ice. Now the Devils will move up. Stillman, nice little pass to LeBanc, and that one goes up. Upstairs, second time LeBanc has had a real good scoring chance, but he's gone way upstairs.
Clearly really wants to go upstairs.
He's going above the attic, though. There is Cates, cut off. Bouncing around at center ice, Hathaway will gather. And he'll softly play it in. The Devils go back to pick it up. And they turn it over. Here's Hathaway getting the puck to Eklund and across for McDonald. McDonald with a shot and a save by Poulter. Hathaway hands it back to McDonald. He's wrestled down by Meltzer, although from his knees, able to recapture the puck, but now it bounces and goes to Max Graham. Graham ahead, looking for Allen, but the Flyers broke that up. Oliver Vaughn across to McDonald, Northeastern product. Pass to Hathaway, tries to dance around the world. He did, but just lost control of it. Now Bonk has it back. Bonk down low, the tip. And that one off Eklund went wide. This is that big reach of his to get that puck free along the wall. Hobbles after it. Nearly got out in front, but now it's played to Graham. Stuffed out to center by the Devils. More pushing and shoving. But Bonk controls the puck for Philadelphia. However, Bonk turns this one over. Zaboro will play it. But offside go the Devils. And the Philadelphia, they had numbers in a big way there, but they could not hold the line.
Alexei Kolosov had the goal turned back, and since then he's made a couple of good saves. That one on the redirect. Got a better look on the overhead here. He's moving to his left, and then he kicks that right pad out. So you can see the athleticism in Kolosov there. Good save.
Yeah, I mean, Fedotov's come from Russia. He comes from Belarus. They are perhaps as opposite in terms of style as two goalies can be, Boosh, as that shot from Granz goes wide. There's a deflection wide of Poulter. Flyers get back to it. Cates got it in front. Avon digging away. Noyer, one of the referees skates. He's then checked. Wrap snap it back up the wall for Grimes. Right along the blue line. Now the tip pass to Cates. Turns the shot blocked. And McKinnon will move to center. Cates has him wrapped up, slung in by Mike Hardman. Squires, another one of those passes. He got it out, and the shot from Vandalies may have been deflected again. Kolasov to save and able to gather that rebound. So Kolasov seeing some rubber and able to deny it as long as there's no offside. And celebrate with special guests, giveaways, and more Flyers fun. See you all Wednesday. Can't wait to. It's going to be tough, though. I got to talk to you. Match wits with Elmore Gandy, Jordan Hall, Ashton Sullivan.
Yeah, you're outmatched.
I am.
Sorry about that.
Just, I'll smile a lot.
Sorry, I won't be able to be there.
Yeah, you'll be busy with your TNT duties. What's your first game?
Wednesday, Rangers and Penguins.
Ooh, that'll be a good one.
Yeah.
Be good.
And I'll meet you in Vancouver.
Indeed. Flyers are going out several days early, and they're going to spend at least a day and a half, I think, at Whistler, team bonding. You remember those team bonding gigs, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Always.
Which one did you like? Do you like the one where you have to catch the guy, or the guy has to trust you to catch them when they let you fall?
Yeah, I love that.
Anybody ever let you fall?
Oh, yeah. Jonesy.
Jonesy. I would not want to see Jonesy being the guy that was going
to
catch
me. I remember the one year we had to fill out what's important for a team, and I think Tockett and Jonesy just wrote down goaltending. That's what's important.
That's right. And then he dropped you.
And then looked at me.
Yeah. He just dropped you after saying that. There's Eric Johnson's shot deflected and goes wide. Vandalies got up by Fury. Fury's looked good in this game. He's able to create some things, win some battles like that. Get it back along for Gauthier. Now Fury, check. Anywhere to go with the puck. He wanted to go to the point, but it was cut off. Finally, the Devils do clear. Wilson was checked, and the Flyers will look to move in from center ice. Johnson for Lixell. Lixell turning with it. Drops it down low for Cates. Cates into the slot, just out of the reach of Lixell. Shard back to get a piece of that puck. It does make its way to the Flyers' home. Bonk. We'll chop it to Richard. Now ahead it goes to Lixell. Lixell on the right wing, dropping it off for Cates. Cates in heavy traffic, though. The Devils get it right back. Dowling will move it back across us. She'll move it ahead, but the Flyers send it right back in. 4 minutes to go in this second period. Flyers get the puck. Cates in front. Richard denied. Sprawling save by Poulter. Flyers set up Richard in a good place. Cates after the puck again. Lixell. Lixell waiting. Trying to find a seam in front. Nothing home. Now the Flyers begin to change. McDonald a shot and a save by Poulter. He's looking for a redirection from Richard there. Now Obbles. Down low. Lixell will get it back to the big center iceman. Obbles for Lixell. And now it's Richard again. A shot that's blocked off in front and deflected right through the blue. Back out. Richard is there. Going to skate it to the middle and cut to the circle and then be wrestled to the wall by Stillman. They poke it ahead. LeBanc trying to get there, but a good read by Granz, and he'll gather for Philadelphia. Excel to Andre. Andre dropping it off for Obbles. Obbles makes it back to Granz. Sure, he was expecting that one, and then he just slings it down low. Allen trying to play it up and out, and he does to LeBanc. LeBanc at the line, and he's checked by Hathaway. Play by Hathaway. Now Andre going to stop Allen. Flyers do get the puck. Moving along the right wing wall. McKinnon jabbing it back to Philadelphia ice. 2:35 to go as McKinnon goes back for the Devils to play the puck. For Hallinan. And now Graham. Off a skate. Eklund will get it back to Ginny. Oscar Eklund. That big body moving through center, and from the red line will bounce one into the right of Poulter. Avon trying to get in after that puck. The Devils control. Michael Diot. Ahead, and they'll move the puck to center. Philip Nagaris. Gets some speed to the Philadelphia line. Ginny takes him into the boards. Johnson trying to poke it free. Quite the scrum behind the Philadelphia. That Avon will twirl up the wall, but that was awaiting for that Walensky across ice. Vandalese out of the reach of Johnson, back around the other way. Back out. That shot's there by Kolesov off of the stick of Cam Squires. He saw it all the way.
Easy save there for Kolesov. Good shift for the Cates. Richard Lixell line job. Good job by Cates to get another forecheck, loosen things up, and then create that opportunity to get it out to Anthony Richard. And Richard has Poulter beat, just not able to elevate as the Devil goaltender is able to get that glove arm down and rob Richard. But a terrific play there by Cates on the forecheck to create the opportunity.
It's the thing you get with Noah. He's an outstanding forechecker. I mean, he checks well all over the ice, obviously, but he can get in and create offense off the forecheck.
Yeah, there's been a few plays tonight where he's kind of tried to force things, and, you know, when you get the message from your head coach that they want to see a little bit more, you're going to try to make plays, even if they may not be there. But that one there was just what you talk about, his forecheck, his hard work, creating an opportunity to loosen the puck up and then making a play. So a real good play to build off of there.
Quick shot. They score. LeBanc fired. There was traffic in front. Not sure if it deflected, but the Devils have tied this game late in the second period.
Well, this guy's been shooting the puck high all night long, and he can rip it. As I mentioned earlier in the game, 17 goals back in 18-19 for San Jose. I don't know if this gets redirected on the way in. Certainly there was traffic. Keep an eye here, LeBanc. Hard to tell. I mean, I don't think it hit anybody.
Yeah, it's almost like the screen was pushed out of the way just
right,
as the puck came.
Yeah, right. I mean, he's battling the traffic, and then right as it's on its way, the screen moves. And almost a CNI shot. I got to think LeBanc gets it.
That will be his fourth of the preseason. Nothing new with Kevin LeBanc getting points against the Flyers. In 10 regular season games as a Shark against the Flyers, he had 13 points. 3 goals, 10 assists. Here's a steal by Andre, his shot. They score! An immediate response from the Flyers as Andre beats Poulter, and the Flyers now lead 3-2.
Well, again, it's the Cates line that does the work. After the goal against, they get out there, and immediately this puck is in the New Jersey Devils zone, and they get to work. Turnover by the Devils with the pressure. Andre on his toes, able to read it, and quickly gets it to the net. You can see Poulter. He's trying to fight through that screen in front that's created by Cates and Jakub Zboril. And see how low the goaltender gets trying to find it. He had no idea where it was. And Andre able to rip it over the glove of Poulter to regain the lead.
16 seconds, all that it took for the Flyers to answer the LeBanc goal. And Andre has his first of the preseason.
Last minute of play in the second period. The
Flyers with the lead into the final minute of this second stanza. There's a turnover, though, and Stillman, who's up to Andre, comes over and gets the puck right back.
52 seconds. Emil Andre scores for the Flyers.
Air will drop it back. McKinnon doesn't get it past Helge Bronz. The work there, though, by Malone to get the puck back for the Devils. They clear it in. Kolesov stabs it to the corner. All white jerseys there. Laguerre after it. Back up the wall. McKinnon knocks it down. Flips one. Deflected, but went through the slot wide. Andre leading on a Devil on the other side of the ice. And Al Eklund will get to Granz. 18 seconds to go in the period as he hustles the puck to center. Granz dropping it back to Eklund. Eklund getting all kinds of room. Fired. That one took off to the corner. Kept in by Obbles, but look out, one last push, but that goes off the linesman and into the Philadelphia.
Yeah, I mean, Eklund, the great thing is he's moving one way but shoots the other. And that could be a tough pickup for a goaltender. If he hits the spot, this puck could have found the far side of the net. Watch how Eklund is moving to his right, and then he shoots back to the left. As a goaltender, you got to try and fight not to move too much, right? You know, you've got to line up with the puck, not the body. And it looked like that far side might have been open just a bit. Just a near miss for Eklund.
Off the draw, Hathaway had been stopped. Second try, couldn't get out in front. And that'll do it for period number two. Hathaway having some words with Graham. Then Graham, after he had some help arrive, decided to get his arms up in the face of Hathaway. He wasn't too interested in doing it at first, but either on second thought or realizing he had a little help, he decided to push and shove, and they will separate peacefully as the period comes to an end.
Here, Hathaway, and I would have counted it and get it to the net right there. He tries to jam it. We'll shove at the end, and nice exchange of pleasantries there at the end of the second period. Good response by the Flyers, though, late.
A-State GMC Dealers. 3-2, Flyers with a lead. As we are just about set to start the third period, let's go stargazing, courtesy of GMC. A lot of people are gazing at this guy tonight to see if he can make one last push to make a roster spot. Will excel, has a goal, a couple shots, plus two. He's certainly made a good account of himself here tonight, Boosh. And I mean, his situation might have so much to do with whether Jet Luchenko makes the team.
Yeah, I mean, he's doing the best he can in this preseason and trying to find a way to be on this team when they go out to Vancouver. And you got to give him credit. I mean, this line has been really all over it. I mean, they've been great on the walls. They've hunted pucks down. They've made plays. And Lixell, you know, really, I think, is trying his best to find a way into this lineup. As he picks up that loose change goal that he scores in the first period. But you're right. I mean, it all depends on what they do with Jet Luchenko. Do they want to keep eight defensemen? Still a lot to be determined, but Lixell trying his very best to make sure he's on that opening night roster.
Underway in period number three is the aforementioned. Mr. Lixell dumps the puck into the Devils' zone. Zavorov back after it. Pokes it ahead, and LeBanc will move it further for Dowling. He overskated, but LeBanc carries on. He'll drop it off. Down low it goes into the Philadelphia zone. Back out in front for a shot at Kolesov. A nice save there on LeBears to keep the Flyers on top. Early push by the Devils. Jennings to Johnson. So Kolesov replaced Fedotov midway through that second period. There's Obbles. Hathaway got away from him. Now McKinnon for New Jersey up the glass and out through center ice. Andre got a piece of it, but the Devils are after it. Now Obbles could not clear. There's Flyers had some nice passes in this game. They get the puck back out. McKinnon, a shot blocked. Eklund will push it down the ice and chase. But he's going to get beat to the puck, but then uses his stick to recover the puck. Got it out to the point. Grant for a shot, and it skipped wide. Eklund will get it back out to Andre, and now Eklund again. His pass for Obbles is intercepted and cleared by Squires. This has definitely been the best we've seen from Oscar Eklund here in camp. Made his presence felt.
Yeah, you can see that he's big and strong. You know, I think maybe at times earlier in the preseason, maybe the speed of the game was probably something you need to work at. But you know, in this game here tonight, he's looked big and strong on the wall. He's won pucks. Real impressive game.
Long stays with that one. Gauthier could not clear it. And now Andy Walensky. Up it down low. That is there. McDonald, nice job shielding the puck. Gauthier up the wall, hoping for Garrett Wilson. It's tucked back down low by the Devils. Allen tries to center it. Gauthier intercepts. And Garrett Wilson winds up with the puck. He'll twist back with it. And now Wilson drop it off as the Flyers complete a line change. Vaughn to McDonald off a stick in center. Gathered by New Jersey. Here's Laguerre. Herded to the wall by Ginning. McDonald will escape with the puck. And now Hutter off the glass and out to center ice. Hathaway looking for it. Devils pick it up. Nice little pass there. Stillman moves in. And with a shot, save made by Kolesov. Left the rebound sitting there as it went off. That's the shaft of his stick. Lone along the wall. Check, Denoy able to jab it out to the neutral zone. Shule trying to get rid of Denoy. Could not. Avon to the puck, but his pass knocked down. And now Chase Stillman, who is indeed the son of longtime NHL veteran Corey. And the brother of Riley Stillman. got the puck in. We got a penalty here as Johnson was clipped. So a delayed call here against the Devils. Johnson then tripped by Albert. It could have been another penalty call. Still no whistle. Looked like the Devils touch point. Well, finally they do blow it dead. And so we get the penalty call. Eventually.
16, New Jersey, Meyer penalty hooking.
So the hooking call against Laguerre.
Sticking on the hands of Eric Johnson. It's been there for a while. I mean, my goodness. Easy call for Rooney to make. Chris Rooney, the official.
Yeah, the veteran. He worked the Stanley Cup Finals.
Yeah, short summer for Mr. Rooney.
A little bit of a different atmosphere.
I'd say so.
Preseason hockey does not quite reach game. I'm not sure if it was game six or game seven. He worked one of the latter games in the finals between Edmonton and Florida. As did you. National radio. Here's Andre. All the way across the shot. They score. What a feed by Andre. And Anthony Richard able to bury it. Power play goal for the Flyers. And they lead 4-2.
What a pass here by Emil Andre. Now, Anthony Richard, one of those guys who's fighting for that last roster spot as well. And I think he's looked good in the preseason. Good speed. Creates opportunities, but this one's created by Andre. Up top, able to find the seam. Richard able to kind of get disengaged and get wide. And that's a perfectly placed one-timer by Richard after the great pass. And the Flyers got a little bit of cushion.
Richard, 27 years of age. There's Andre. Richard, last year, 9 games with the Bruins. He's also played some games with Montreal and Nashville at the NHL level. Almost 500 games in the AHL. You see a guy with his speed and his skill, and you see those numbers, it makes you realize how tough it is to actually become a permanent NHL player.
Well, right, because he's probably more suited, his game, the way he skates, you think he'd be more of a top six player. Tough to crack in the National Hockey League, so can he be a bottom six player? I think that's something that's a role that maybe he's going to grow into throughout his pro career. Maybe he's at the point in his career now where it's something that he can do. But I got to be honest with you. I mean, I really like this preseason. His speed stands out to me. He has good instincts. And you can see here on the power play how he just kind of hangs out, doesn't get involved, trusts his teammates that eventually they'll make a play, and Andre does. You can see how wide he gets, and then here, not an easy one-timer, but he's able to bury that on the beautiful feed, and I just think Richard's looked really good. Again, it's going to be a tough decision for the Flyers to make as to who sticks, but Richard, Lixell, Lechenko, they've all made it pretty difficult for the management to figure out who's going to stay up front.
But those are the difficult kind of decisions you want to have, right?
Yep.
Because people are really emerging, and it's what John Tortorella and Ashland referred to this earlier in the broadcast, was hoping he'd see on defense, and I think we're seeing a little bit of that from Andre here tonight, but where a player really jumps out and says, hey, I'm ready.
Yeah.
And they've had that from some of the forwards. And Andre. Adam Jennings been much better tonight, as he even said. We'll try to give at least a good final impression to John Tortorella here in training camp. That point shot goes wide of a screen. Kolasov.
For defensemen that play a physical game, or anybody who plays a physical game for that matter, sometimes it's hard to get that engine going in the preseason when you're so used to playing summer hockey, and it's about skills and skating and not really giving or receiving the contact, to kind of get your mind wired to get back into that mode. And I think for Jennings it's been much more visible here tonight. I think McDonald's been physical as well, but sometimes that can be difficult to get out of a player early on in the preseason right out of the hop.
Andre gonna have to deal with some forechecking here, and he does so with a plum. Got that puck ahead. Is it Furry off to Wilson? Bruce is trying to figure out what fruit I'm talking about. It's a phrase, a plum.
Oh.
Actually, the late, great Gene Hart used to use that.
Okay.
Time to time. I didn't literally mean he had a plum out there. Like that.
You know how you said sometimes you're not listening to me?
You weren't listening. It's probably a good thing. You had a quizzical look on your face. I figured you were trying to... What is he talking about, a plum? Anyhow, Walensky sends that puck in. It was up over the glass.
I think we're going to break, JJ.
Yeah, I think we need one. All right. We absolutely do. 4-2 Flyers.
Very bright future, but as of right now, it's just playing too slow in his mind. Does it make sense why this is happening? A 19-year-old defenseman for one reason, and that's to be expected. But number two, when you become really good at the junior level, the game gets easier for you, and you catch yourself pacing yourself when you play at that junior level. John Tortorella wants to see Oliver Bonk play at that NHL level all the time, guys.
Yeah, I think he's been better here tonight.
Yeah,
moving the puck a little more quickly.
You know what I like, too? I like how the Flyers have kept him around through all of camp. I think that's so important. There's some organizations that would have sent a junior player down by now. Even, you know, Luchenko is one thing because I think he has an opportunity to make the team. But, you know, if Bonk's going to go back to junior, a lot of teams would have sent the guy down by now. But you keep him around, see if he can improve, see if he can coach him. I think it's valuable experience for him to be here. He's going to be a good NHL defenseman. Obviously, he's got pedigree. And he wants to learn, and that's an important quality.
Yeah, and when you watch him, you forget he's only 19. That's so young for a defenseman. Usually it takes a defenseman a little bit longer than a forward to get some of the intricacies of the game. Devils put some pressure on here. A backhander by Laguerre went just wide. From the point, that shot deflects wide. Rutsky fired away. Ginny jabs it to Johnson. Set it up the wall, but the Devils are ready for that. The Shule on behind the net. Good work by Cates. Versus that puck. We had some of the good defensive work from Noah Cates right there. Took what looked like a dangerous foray by the Devils in the offensive zone and just completely ended it. And the Devils move back up. 8 minutes into this third period. Turn it over at the Flyer line, half the way up the left wing. And his pass went back to center. Bach will have to go back and get it. To McDonald and then off of Hathaway. He's knocked down by LaBerge at the New Jersey line. Zaboral moving across. Mishul out to this. Spotted down by Obbles. Nice pass to Hathaway. Hathaway looking to get it to Eklund, but it was poked away from him. And Kevin LeBanc set sail the other way. LeBanc to the Philadelphia line. Twists and turns. Rolls it around behind the cage. Hathaway kept Dowling away from it. Now Obbles to Eklund. And a one-handed in. McKinnon stopped that bid. And now the Flyers regather at their own line. Probably going to go back behind the zone. Now Donald trying to get to that. Worked by Denoyer to get in the way of a Devils player. Denoyer trying to get that puck back. But the Devils have a set point shot blocked and taken by Obbles. He got it to the line. Knocked down with a high stick. Then off a Flyer to a Devils. So we play on. Hardman sent flying along the wall with that hit. And Sawyer Bolton. And the puck to Bonk. Bonk. Got up by Hardman along the corner board. Denoyer will move it ahead. And Sawyer Bolton will lift it out to center ice. Bolton finally served all that penalty time. We got a penalty coming up here on Philadelphia. Delayed call as Franz gets there. There's your whistle. So the Devils will get a bad advantage and a chance to get back within one.
Philadelphia, 85, 2 minutes for holding.
Inside Edge season ticket memberships for the 24-25 season are available now. Get exclusive benefits, concessions and merchandise discounts, new rewards and more. Join the team and become a member today at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com. J.R. Avon. The box for holding that left arm grabs on to New Jersey defender Michael Diott, and he sits for two.
The Devils are looking to score with a bad advantage. LeBanc dropping it back. Dowling. Kept hit by Walensky. He has some Flyers looking to break the other way. The Bears give him some rough treatment by Granz. Centering pass, snuffed out by Andre, who banks it all the way down. Well, Andre, then only 22, and continues to look really good in this one. Obbles will send this puck back deeper into the double zone. Nowitzki looking to start the Devils up ice. Drops to Dowling. Now it's LeBanc. His pass across ice deflects deep into the zone. That's careening into the glass. LeBanc wants to tell him he's got to leave the ice.
Penalty. It's going to be on Johnson.
LeBanc shot blocked, so delayed call here. LeBanc has gone to the bench. The extra attacker with the goalie pulled is out. LeBanc's pass here, though, intercepted. And so the whistle stops play. 53 seconds still left on the Avon Miners with some 5-on-3 time for the Devils.
Flyers
fans, stream your team when you're on the go with the NBC Sports app. Presented by Lundy Law, your injury lawyers.
At real speed, what I saw from Johnson is he's trying to avoid contact, and you know, he's got two players barreling in on him, and he's just trying to avoid the contact from LeBerge. LeBerge sells it. I mean, clearly the glove comes up and catches LeBerge's helmet, but LeBerge brought some attention to it by snapping that head back.
Big face-off win by Cates. The Flyers get to clear the puck all the way down, which takes time off the 5-on-3. As the Devils re-enter, 40 seconds remain on the two-man advantage. Walensky sits down low out to LeBanc for a shot. Snared by Kolesov. Saw that one all the way, even though there was some traffic in front of him.
To me, I like this, you know, having to kill a 5-on-3 to see what Kolesov can do. Big face-off win by Cates. So important, as you mentioned, you know, when you're down 5-on-3, I mean, get that face-off, get the clear. You know, just get some work here for Kolesov. See what he's got. Good save there on the bank.
There's a blast from Walensky, blocked by Kranz. Get it back to LeBanc. 22 seconds in the 5-on-3. LeBanc. It's a Dowling. Now LeBanc the blast, and he scores off the post and in. And the power play goal makes it 4-3, and still 1:23 left on the Johnson Minor. LeBanc's got to his second of the night.
He can rip it, can he? He can shoot the puck, and this little give and go here is LeBanc drives, gets it down low to Dowling, back to LeBanc, and you know, Kolesov goes down on that near side post, and when you go down like that, I know the goaltenders are doing it nowadays, but unless you think he's really going to take it to the net, you know, I wonder if the thought to hold your feet there would allow you to get in a position better at the top of your crease, but even with that, I mean, it was a perfectly placed shot by LeBanc off the pipe and in the second of the night.
Well, LeBanc now 5 goals in his last 3 games here in the preseason.
I don't think he can catch a plane to Prague in time, but
you wonder if some other team, if the Devils choose not to sign him,
right?
See that?
I mean, if there's one knock on Kevin LeBanc, it's that, you know, he's not familiar with his own zone yet, right? But there's no doubt he can shoot. And we've seen it here tonight.
This is there by Rodrigo Abels. He clears it all the way down. 42 seconds left on the Devils' power play as they try to tie this game now. Whirl ahead. Chase Stillman got it in. He's right there, though, turns away from the forechecker and scales it all the way down the ice. So that'll leave time for just one more push with the power play for the Devils. LeBanc couldn't handle that pass. Shea backhanded back through center ice. McKinnon dropped it. Hartman hit the referee with his dump-in. And Andre's right there to sail it out just out of the reach of Furry. But it acts as a clear just the same, which ends the Devils' power play. The Flyers back to full strength as LeBanc surges in across the line. And flip it around behind. Donald cuts it off. Dowling digs away at him. The puck to Cates. Noah will be rammed into by Hartman, but does clear the zone. So we tick below 7 minutes remaining in the third in a one-goal hockey game in the final preseason game for the Flyers. Try to end above 500 preseason record. Entering this one at 3-3. LeBanc pursued by Bonk. Goes across ice. Lots of room for Walensky. He'll send it in front. Redirected just wide. That was close. Now Bonk bounces that one to center. That's knocked down. Dowling will find it. Play it back to Walensky. Walensky will get to Andalist. He will send it back in. And the Flyers get to that puck. Richard clears the zone. Walensky has it back. He's only had three shots on goal here in the third period. The pass deflects in. Ginning will go back for it. The puck bounces free. Devil center it. The shot by Laguerre is blocked. That was a pretty easy recovery of the puck for the Devils. Myers after it now, and Avon able to get it out to center ice. Turnover, Avon in, but still in the zone as Bolton, and so offside is whistled. 5:48 remaining in the third. Let's go places. And by Wells Fargo, together we'll go far. Beautiful look at Philadelphia. 4-3 the score here as we're just about done with the preseason. It's time to look at that month of October. So much going on in the sports world in October, including the start of the NHL season for the Flyers. It begins on the 11th, four straight on the road, and then six of the next eight at home, including a home-and-home there with Washington. Interesting start to the season.
I tell you, I'm glad we're hitting Calgary, Edmonton in October.
Yes.
And not January.
We may see a flurry or two, but it'll be, you know, above minus 20, which is good.
Good to get on the road right off the hop. I mean, a lengthy road trip. As you mentioned, these guys are going to do some bonding in Whistler, British Columbia. But get away and hopefully get off to a good start and set the tone right for the season with a good, solid road trip.
Flyers, they have a thing of opening against Vancouver, don't they?
They do.
Quite a bit. They'll also play their home opener against Vancouver this year. Here's Andre, and to knife his way to the slot. Goes back to Ginning for a shot. Save made. Poulter, the rebound. Hobbles has it. He'll turn it back down low. Hathaway couldn't knock it down. Johnson jumps off the bench and into the play. Ram over there for the Devils. Zaboro pops free. Johnson to Hobbles. Out it goes. They'll play it across. Eklund to Ginning. His shot blocked off. Allenden will flutter it to center where Ginning grabs it. Quickly ahead. And Hathaway trying to hold off Nishua. The other way it goes. Cates. Cates tucks it down low. Excel trying to spin away from LeBanc. Will Excel. Trying to get that puck back to Cates, but the Devils were up to it. LeBanc nearly stripped, but able to go back and get the puck. Across ice to McKinnon. Now Diot ahead. That's turned over. Richard with the steal. Nice pass to Excel. Excel turned back. Looking for an outlet. Got it to the point. Bonk. His shot. Gloved by Poulter. And play comes to a stop. One last break. 4:07 to go in the third.
Score a 24-ounce Yingling traditional lager, an exclusive co-branded koozie with the Yingling Night Out Package, available only at PhiladelphiaFlyers.com.
Well, for the first time in over a decade, the NHL will take a break in the middle of the season for an international tournament. Four nations face off in mid-February. USA, Canada, Finland, and Sweden in a round-robin tournament. Starts played in Boston, Montreal. Should be a lot of fun, Bush. I know guys like Connor McDavid, they've never been involved in anything like this.
Crazy, not, huh?
Yeah, so it'll be fun to watch. Got a country, it's a favorite. Is Canada the outright favorite?
I mean, the only thing about Canada, they've got everything but a goaltender. I mean, to me, that's their big question. I mean, who's going to play goal for them? Can Roberto Luongo come out of retirement?
I don't think so. Yeah, there's no clear-cut guy.
But they are loaded in every other position. United States should be very good.
They certainly have the goaltender.
Yes, it's going to be a fun tournament, and you know, and it's a precursor to what's to come with the Olympics,
right,
which is going to be excellent. And I think it's good that we have best on best reappearing here with the NHL talent.
Right here, this one going down to the wire with 3:40 to go. Flyers up by one. No question. I think everybody involved here wants this one to end in regulation.
I agree with you. Big time.
I wanted us to end the preseason on the same note. Here's Andre to Furry up the left wing. Burst of speed from Furry. Centers it. It went off the stick of Garrett Wilson and wide. And now Schmelzer the other way to bank. Almost too many men on the ice for the Devils. Not. Moves that one to Schmeltzer. His right wing feed jammed in by Graham. Bonk is back, but a man out of it. Hallinan came away with that puck. Got it out to the point. They move it to Gatton. Sends it wide. Schmeltzer behind the net. Steps into by Bonk. The puck's behind Oliver. No. And then Gaucher leans into his man. The clock ticks down to 2:42. As they dig for it in the corner. Meltzer and Hallinan, Gaucher and McDonald. Finally, it comes free. And the Devils have it. Hallinan back out. And Elise sends it wide. Try to center it. It got right into the blue and came across crease. But bounced away. Devils still holding their goaltender in the net with 2:18 to go, even though they had the Flyers pinned pretty well there. Now, Bonk relieves the pressure. Moves it to Gaucher and then Furry. Furry worked on by Vandalese. Devils have it back. Yacht to the red line and in. They're staying put. Eric Johnson hammers it up the boards and out. Again, almost too many men on the ice. This time it's called, I believe. It is. With 1:55 to play, too many men on the ice against the Devils. So if they pull a goalie now, they'll be doing so just to even things.
New Jersey has a bench minor for too many men on the ice.
Devin Dineen not happy.
A little mishap. You got to think that, you know, he's probably telling the player that was going to be taking the goaltender, except someone jumped on these guys. They've got some decisions to make after this game as to who stays and who goes. But to me, I think it's been a real productive preseason for this Flyers team.
I look at Jonesy when you say who stays and who goes, and I just hope he's not making any changes to the TV broadcast team, because he did give us a warning at the start of the game. But as far as the team, the roster has to be set in at 5 o'clock on Monday. That's when you have to be down to 23. We'll see what the Flyers do. I think we've stayed out of trouble so far. A long season.
I'll keep you honest. You keep me honest.
I'll try. Sure. There's Andre back. Devils not showing signs of pulling their goalie at this point. They're down a man. But down a goal. Flyers move the puck ahead. It's Andre. Play to the right wing for Lixell. Lixell turns with it. And got it. Fourth. Down low. The pass back out in front. Cates. To Richard. To Cates. He scores. Somebody had to shoot the puck, and it was Noah Cates who fires it home to make it 5-3 Philadelphia. Power play goal, their third of the night.
Well, we talked about Cates in the open, right? Trying to find offense, create offense. His line has been all over it here tonight. And, you know, a late power play. And I don't care if it's preseason, power play, 5-on-3, or even 5-on-5, or empty net. If you're asked to score goals and create offense, putting the puck in the back of the net is important. For Noah Cates, it may seem like a meaningless goal in a preseason game, but I can bet you for him, really happy for him to score, and he's probably happy too. He had a chance earlier in the game, where one timer he wasn't able to elevate, but that one he is able to get through the legs, gets his first of the preseason, and can feel good about his exhibition season.
Richard ends up with a 3-point night. Goal and two assists. The goalie is halfway to the bench. Then Holter decides to go back to the crease as the Flyers get the puck. And here's Eklund up the right wing. Eklund backhands all the way through. McDonald.
Get that deep. Along with number 36.
Now Andre. Also a 3-point night. The goal and two helpers.
Okay,
got the secondary
power
assist
play
on that goal. Jinning across. And set in, and both Richard and Andre have had strong camps. Boosh. And ended in 3-point nights.
Yep. And now the decision will be out of their hands. But they can feel good about themselves and the way that they performed in this last game. And as I mentioned, I think Richard had a strong camp.
He's noticeable. That's what you got to do. The goalie's pulled here. save there by Kolasov with the rebound. And that's rammed home. And who else? Kevin LeBanc in the right spot at the right time. He's got himself a hat trick.
This guy might have earned himself an NHL contract with his finish here tonight. Goal scorers tend to have the puck follow them around, and this puck just kind of squibbles out to where LeBanc is kind of hanging out, and he's able to put it home. And whether it's in New Jersey or somewhere else, LeBanc, you can bet with his preseason, he's on some team's radar, that's for sure.
Twice he had over 30 goals and 100 points in junior hockey, and then, as you mentioned, 17 goals in 2019 with the Sharks, so he's capable. Timeout called here with 10.2 seconds remaining.
Here's your goal.
Tell you who our Chevrolet player of the game is.
Yeah, it's Emo Andre, who's had a strong game. Again, one of those guys that's fighting for a spot in this team and a last chance to make a good impression, and he's done it here tonight. A goal and two assists, but he's made several good plays throughout the night, whether it be five on five or on the power play. And he's hoping that what he did is enough to stick around when this team heads out west.
So with a timeout, the Devils will leave their goalie on the bench. 10.2 seconds. All that they have left to try to work with here. They struggle to get that puck free. It comes free. LeBanc to Stillman, goes back across for Walensky. His backhand is deflected into the air, goes out of play. Time runs out. They may put some time back on the clock because it looked as though there was some time remaining for the puck went out of play. The horn blows. The fans think the game's over, but Chris Rudy has already signaled, hold on a second here. Let's see what they're going to put back on, and there will be a faceoff apparently to the right of Alexei Kolasov. This had to happen, right? You got to extend the preseason a bit.
It looked like there might have been 0.9 is what I was guessing. At that point, I agree, just let it run, but looks like we're going to stick around for one more faceoff. 1.1. I was wrong. Maybe I was exaggerating with 0.9.
Okay, 0.2 of a second. It's pretty close.
I don't think it's enough time. I don't think I've ever seen a goal in 1.1 go in.
It'd have to be a shot by Dowling right here. He tries to force it to the net. They got it out in front. That 1.1.
That was the longest 1.1 in the history of 1.1.
I say the preseason is over, and the Flyers end it with a victory. Kolasov in relief for Fedotov. Andre, 3 points. Richard, 3 points. And a 5-4 Philadelphia victory. They end their preseason slate at 4-3.
Well, a good finish for the Flyers. A victory, obviously. The most important thing is that it seems like everybody is healthy. That's a positive. Some young guys perform well in this training camp. And I think some other guys have planted a seed that if they're not here opening night roster, perhaps they can be call-ups. But this preseason's in the books, JJ, and when we get back together, it's gonna matter.
Yeah, it'll matter, all right. The regular season, and that's what's next up. Next Friday, October the 11th, in Vancouver, our coverage at NBC Sports Philadelphia that night begins at 9:30. Scotty Hart, Noel Morgani, Ashton Sullivan back with pregame live. For our entire crew, including producer Casey Pink, director Mike Mulligan, and my partners Brian Boucher and Ashton Sullivan, I'm Jim Jackson. Thanks for watching. Bird's Huddle is coming up next.
Let's drop the puck.
Let's drop the